In this video, we'll try to understand how to draw shear force diagram and bending moment diagram in case of simply supported beam carrying uniformly distributed load. Now the arrangement of the beam is as shown over here. The UDL of 50 kN per meter is acting for a distance of 2 meter from the left hand support A, and a uniformly distributed load of 20 kN per meter is acting at a distance of 2 meter from the right hand support B. Now, first thing we have to find out these reactions RA and RB. So we'll convert this particular uniformly distributed load into a point load. So the meaning of UDL is for 1 meter length, the load that is acting is 50 kN. Then for 2 meter length, the load that is acting will be 100 kN and it will be acting at the center of this rectangular distribution. Similarly, over here also, the UDL load will be 20 into 2, that is 40 kN, and will be acting at the center of this rectangular distribution. So we have converted that uniformly distributed load into point load. Now this point load is acting at the center, so over here it will be acting for a distance of 1 meter and over here also it is acting for a distance of 1 meter. Now we'll apply the conditions of equilibrium to find out the reactions. The first condition of equilibrium is summation of Fy is equal to 0, that is summation of forces in y direction is equal to 0, upward forces are positive and downward forces they are considered as negative. Now RA and RB, they are acting in the upward direction, so they are considered as positive, whereas this 100 kN load, it is acting in the downward direction. This 40 kN load, that is also acting in the downward direction, so that is equal to 0. So we can say that RA plus RB is equal to 140. Now we'll apply the another condition of equilibrium, that is summation of moments is equal to 0, clockwise positive and anticlockwise moments will consider negative. Now start from this RB, the arrow of this reaction RB will be going in the anti-clockwise direction towards A, so it is minus RB, and from B to A the perpendicular distance is 6, so it is minus RB into 6 because it is in the anti-clockwise direction. This 40 kN point load will produce the clockwise moment towards A, so or about A, and the perpendicular distance from this point up to A will be 2 + 2 + 1, that is 5, and as it is clockwise it is positive. Similarly, this 100 kN load, that will also produce the clockwise moment, so it is 100 × 1. So we can say that 40 × 5, that is 200 + 100, so it is 300, and transfer is negative term on the other side, so we will get the value of RB as 50 kN. Now substitute that value of RB in equation 1, so we'll get the value of RA also, so it is 140 minus RB, so that is 90 kN. So the reactions we have calculated as 90 and 50 kN. Now we have to draw the shear force diagram. The conventions for drawing the shear force diagram are: upward forces they are considered as positive, whereas downward forces they are considered as negative. So shear force at A will be 90 kN and this is acting in the upward direction, so it is positive. Shear force at the left of the C, we have to consider all the forces which are acting on the left of the C. So RA, which is acting in the now in the upward direction, so it is positive, and 50 × 2, that is the 100 kN, that is acting in the downward direction, so it is minus 10 kN. The same shear force will act at point C also, because there is no other point load that is acting at point C. Now between C and D there is no other force that is acting on the beam, so whatever the shear force that we have calculated at point C, the same will remain at point D also. At the left of the B, we have to take into consideration this uniformly distributed load of 20 × 2, so it is minus 10, which we have obtained up to point D, and to that we have to add 20 × 2 in the downward direction, that is 40 kN. So minus 10 minus 40, that is minus 50 kN. But exactly at point B, there is another reaction which is acting in the upward direction, so minus 50, which we have calculated earlier at the left of the B, and to that we have to add upward reaction 50 of 50 kN, so it is 0 kN. Now using these values we can draw shear force diagram. So first we'll draw the baseline or reference line. Shear force at A is 90 kN. At left of the C, and C it is minus 10 kN, remains same up to point D. Then at left of the B it is minus 50 kN, and at exactly at B it is 0. So the respective values we have already written on this particular diagram. Now we have to draw the bending moment diagram. Before that we'll find out the point of zero shear. So this is the point of zero shear, where shear force diagram, it changes the sign from positive to negative. So consider this section at a distance x from A as shown over here. Now we'll concentrate only at that particular, on that particular section. So to find out the point of zero shear, so concentrate on this section xx acting at a distance x from the left hand support, that is A. So on the left hand side of this section xx, the forces which are acting is Ra, which is acting in the upward direction, that is positive, minus 50 into x. So as it is acting in the downward direction, it is negative. And the shear force is zero at this particular section. Transfer this negative 50 term on this side, it will become positive. So x will be equal to 90 divided by 50, that is 1.8 meter from A. Now on this particular point of zero shear, the bending moment will be maximum. So our next job will be to find out the value of maximum bending moment. So we'll convert that particular UDL into a point load acting at the center of this x, that is x by 2. So 50 into x is the UDL, and acting at the center of x, that is x by 2. And now we have to find out the moments about this particular section xx. So consider all the forces on the left hand side of this xx. So 90, which is the reaction Ra, will produce clockwise moment about section xx, so it is 90 into x. And this 50x will produce anti-clockwise moment about this particular, so it is 50 into x into x by 2, so that is negative because it is producing anti-clockwise moment. So we can say that bending moment at this particular section xx is 90x minus 50 x square upon 2, or substitute the value of x, that is 1.8. so at this particular x is 1.8, here also it is 1.8, so we'll get the value of maximum bending moment as 81 kilonewton meter. Now we'll find out the bending moment at the various other section. Now we know that bending moment at point A will be zero because there is no force that is acting on the left hand side of A. Bending moment at xx we have already calculated, that is 81 kilonewton meter. Now we have to find out what will be the bending moment at point C. So we have to consider all the forces which are acting on the left hand side of C. So on the left hand side of C we are having Ra, that is 90 kN, and it is producing clockwise moment about C. So it is 90 into 2. The perpendicular distance between A and C is 2. Then the UDL, 50 into 2. That is 100 kN, and it will be acting at the center of 2 meter length, that is 1 meter, but that will be producing anti-clockwise moment. So it is minus 100 into 1. So 90 into 2 minus 100 into 1. So that comes out to be 80 kN meter. Now bending moment at point D. Again consider all the forces which are acting on the left hand side of A. So this is 90. And from A to D, the perpendicular distance is 4, so it is 90 into 4. This 100 kN, it will produce anti-clockwise moment about point D, so it is 100 into 1 plus 2, that is 3. So this 100 kN from this point up to point D, the perpendicular distance is 1, this 1 plus 2, that is 3, so it is 60 kN meter. Then bending moment at point B will be zero because there is no other force that is acting on the right hand side of P. Okay. Or even if you calculate considering all the forces on the left hand side, the value that will become will be, the value that comes out will be zero. So at end points there will not be any bending moment. Now we'll consider all these particular values and then we'll draw this bending moment diagram. So at A it is zero, then from A to C there is u.d.l which is acting, so there will be a parabolic curve because it is the second degree equation that will obtain. Now within that we are having the bending moment at this section xx, which we have already calculated, and it will be maximum, it is 81 kilonewton meter. So out of all the values you can see that the bending moment at section xx where shear force is zero is always maximum, that is 81 kilonewton meter. Then from C to D there is no load that is acting, so there will be a straight line, and there will be again a parabolic curve from D to B because this is the second degree equation that will obtain over here as there is a u.d.l. So in this way we can draw the shear force and bending moment diagram in case of simply supported beam carrying uniformly distributed load. Thank you very much for watching.